Hey y'all, it's Sheila. Hope you're having a great day. I want to pop on just for a few minutes, give you an update on my appointment Saturday. You know, I went Friday for the ultrasound thinking it was fluid buildup causing my incision to open. That was not the case. And I was very disappointed and quite worried. My doctor called me and had me meet him at 10 o'clock on Saturday at his office. And he explained to me that fluid building up would not have been a good thing at all. I had three sections of my incision that did open up, but they didn't open up deeply. One section's about this long now. He told me it would open up some more, and it did. He also told me that in 6 to 9 months, when we go in to do the left breast to make it match the new breast, that he could work on that incision. On my sides, the cut from hip to hip, the very outsides of my hips have healed, and there is the faintest thin line. This is in the middle, and he said I'll have a scar about that wide, and when he did my left breast, he would fix that. And I said, I am almost 56 years old. Nobody's going to see that incision but you and David. Perhaps another doctor. Once it's healed, leave it alone. I'm not really worried about a stomach scar. He said, well, we'll see if you still feel that way when we do your other breast. And I'm 99.9% sure I'm still going to feel that way, because I think refreshing that scar would involve cutting. And once it's healed up, I'm saying, leave it be. He changed the way we were doing the dressings. He added another dry gauze to it. I'm not doing wet to dry dressings and all that kind of thing. He won't let it go that far. If it opens up more and deeply, he'll simply take me to the operating room, open it up, refresh it, and sew it back up. Not months and months of months of trying to heal this area. He will not do that, and I'm thankful for that. He told me that I could go out some. I had been out of the house 3 times, once to my mom's for supper, once to the nail salon, and once to ride with David to go through a drive-thru. I still cannot bend, lift. I'm still pretty much in this recliner here in my bedroom, or in the bed, or in that chair, or walking around the house. That's pretty much it. No pulling, tugging. I can lift my pink cup I drink out of, and that's about it. I was really disappointed that it opened up, because I felt like things were going so well. That kind of threw me for a little mini loop. He did put me on antibiotics again, and they just make me feel kind of, I'm not having any vomiting or bathroom issues with it. They just make me feel bad. And it is the same antibiotic, just in a different strength, that I have had to use for my rosacea. And I remembered this morning, yesterday, I just felt, ugh. And I remembered this morning, that's the same way doxycycline made me feel the first month I took it for rosacea. And it will pass, but I don't plan to be on this for a month. In the meantime, on Saturday, David said, well, he said you could go for a ride. Where do you want to go? And I'm like, well, I placed one of those 2-day Walmart orders that was supposed to have been here on the 6th, and it's not here. And it had trash bags and some things we needed for around the house. I said, so let's ride to Walmart. He said, oh, I don't want you going in there. There's too many people and kids running around. So I took the buggy, planted it in front of me, and he walked holding the buggy too. And yes, there were children running and screaming through Walmart. I don't understand parents that allow that. I don't. I saw an elderly woman with a prosthetic leg nearly getting knocked over. And David's going, get what you need and let's get out of here now. One thing that did not come from Walmart, of course, that I wanted to talk more about is the Shiseido BB Sport. I have normal skin. Straight, middle of the road, normal skin. This does not bother my skin. If you have dry or very dry skin, this may not be moist enough for you, but it does stay in place, and you need to do some, it takes a double cleanse every night for me to get all of this off my face, but I do love it. While I was in Walmart, I wanted a hair treatment. Yes, my hair is getting quite long and needs to be trimmed. It's not completely dry yet. I just washed it, and I wanted some type of hair mask, and I found that. And then I'd seen some videos, people talking about the new Wet n Wild palettes. I'm probably fixing to get in a lot of trouble right here. I will never again buy another Wet n Wild palette product. I will not. This thing was sealed on three sides. There's no edge provided that you can lift up and pull it off. It took me 30 minutes to open this palette with a knife. I understand why it's not in a box. That's one of the reasons that I prefer some of the eyeshadow palettes from Ulta and Sephora and other places like that. They're in a box. I open the box. I open the palette. Then once I got the palette open, this light transition shade goes on chocolate. This dark, dark burgundy goes on non-existent. I've used almost every color in here. They won't blend for me. I'm not knocking it because it's an inexpensive drugstore palette. Y'all know Maybelline the Nudes is one of my favorite, and it has a tab where you can unpeel it completely and then open it. I'm still having trouble with this because some of that tape is still on there. And, you know, I'm all for saving the environment. I'm all for that. But some of us have rheumatoid arthritis, and we don't do well with opening things with our hands that are super glued almost together. Wet n Wild, do something different for us people that struggle with our hands. Yeah. I wanted to say hello to Dolores the Baking Diva. She had a total knee replacement. I know a little about knees. I've never had that. I've never had a total knee replacement, but I know a lot of people that have. She's got a strenuous physical therapy road ahead of her. And Dolores, I love you, and I'm wishing you all the best. And our Jerry from Growing Older with Style, has an appointment with a specialist tomorrow. The first video I did about Jerry, I intended to mention Dolores. I'm still a little loopy. I had 3 pain pills after I came home, and that was it. It's not pain pills, it's the anesthesia. But I wanted to mention Dolores then and forgot about it. I did mention Jerry, and I forgot to link her channel. So anyway, Jerry does have an appointment tomorrow, and Dolores, I'm sending you prayers too. And I know that physical therapy's gonna be tough. And the rest of y'all, I hope you're having a great day. Today's a special day. It's March the 12th. It's my only child's birthday. And it's snowing in North Carolina. 1 year it snowed on his birthday and we got 14 inches. I don't think we're going to get that this year. But happy birthday to my son. Y'all have a great day. Make it a great day. And I'll see you later. Bye now.